Slayer, 7 Days to Die with Silver Blade.
damn it, son of a... Ouch.
You must remember to...
Hey, Miles Power!
Don't you feel foolish?
Greetings, minions, engineers, and fellow gamers. This is Silver Blade playing Space Engineers Beta. And this is episode number 8, as it were. Alright, since the last episode, I've done a bunch of iron mining. Got it all processing there in the atmospheric lander, and we have some work we need to do. Now, one of the things I want to get done, and I'm going to need to get the parts together for this, is I want to create a docking port. So we're going to need couple of these, maybe one of these, and some of these, and some of that, and a crap ton of these. And I think even some steel plate, just for good measure. I think that's all I'm needing, and if not, we can always come back. Alright, so what I've figured out is this is my ingot bin, this is my ore bin, and since this is going to be near an outside wall, I want to put some conveyors up so they'll poke up through the roof and then they'll branch out for multiple direction connectors that I can dock ships to without having to come and land flat on the ground. With the vertical driller that I showed the listing in the blueprints for, it has a docking connector in the rear. And because it's got all those 25 shiny little drills at the bottom, I'd rather not try to land them on this nice light armor deck. So, yeah, I'm going to try to get that taken care of. So let's get her started in here. So first we'll put in, let's see, I want to go two high, go three high, then put in a connector, or a conveyor block junction, as it were. Let's see. There we go. And I want to make sure the labels are sort of right. And okay, that looks good enough. Alright, so this is where the roof level will be. And the reason why I want a connector here, or a junction here, whoa, almost fell. Alright. The reason why I want a conveyor junction up here where the roof blocks will be is because these conveyors here are not airtight, whereas the junctions are. So when I put in the roof, I want to make this whole inner base area airtight so I can put in airlocks and all that happiness. And if I have a conveyor tube sticking through the roof, well, the air is just going to seep out. There will be no air tightness. I won't even be able to pressurize the inside of the base. So to put a block up here, that will seal the deal. Alright, so now we need to get some more connectors. We'll go three up. We'll put in another conveyor junction. There we go. Get this. So we'll have this go out. And let's see. Probably go out maybe two more. Alright, now we need to get a connector. Pop that on the end if we can get it to settle in here just right. And, oop, wrong way. Now, I like to have the lights on top and on bottom. So, get those all popped in. See, it actually looks like I know what I'm doing. So is that small steel tubes? Fine. Yeah, of course. Alright, we'll make sure we got enough of everything then. Looks like that should be plenty. Should, but maybe not. Make sure that's done. And booyah, done. So now I can fly my vertical miner up and connect it to that docking port there. Now I want to build another one. Let's see. Another docking port to go. This way. Kind of keep a little bit of separation from from the other ship, so that if I have the two ships docked, they're not going to interfere with each other. Alright, some more of the inner plates. I'm going to need motors. I'm going to need steel plate. And more tubes. Alright, there we go. And maybe I'll put 100 of those back. There we go. That should get this part done. Alright, so that's all hooked up. Now, I have another ship that the connector is underneath it. So I'm going to want to have... I tend to mix them up a little bit because it's makes it easier for docking, I suppose. And there we go. Now the other ship is a welder ship. Basically does everything that I'm doing right now, but it carries a hell of a lot more. It's also a lot more wobbly, so it's not exactly a stable ship, not by any stretch of the imagination, but it's a good little ship. And there we go. Alright, so dawn is coming. So we have a docking port, docking port up here, so that ships that have an underslung connector can dock here, and then docking port here and over there for ships that have a more horizontal one. So mainly, I think the only two I'm going to be needing will be that one and that one. I might even have another one outside here. Like I might just get into that right now, actually. So we'll put, let's see. Yeah, we're gonna need to put a junction in here. And then let's see. Junction. That kind. Get on that block, you. There we go. Had the wrong size. Alright, and then I'll rotate that. Oh. There we go. Steel plate for that connector. Let's see, what else? No, it's just steel plate. Okay. I like a little bit of flexibility, what can I say? And it's a bit tight in here, I think. We'll see how it goes. If not, I can always tear this down and rebuild it as I need. So with that done, another thing we're going to need to consider is oxygen generation and hydrogen generation and storage. And also oxygen storage. That's what this other side of the base is going to be for. Now, you need the oxygen, obviously, for your air tanks. And the oxygen generators are good for, well, primarily for making all that, you know, not just for your air tank and your hydrogen tanks for your suit and all, but also we're going to want to make a ship that will be run by hydrogen, so we'll need tanks to start building up fuel so we can quickly refuel a hydrogen-powered ship. We'll need oxygen tanks so we can store oxygen to not only fill up our air tanks, but also for pressurization and depressurization, that's a mouthful, of the base itself. Whew, that's a lot of work. And we ain't even got walls and a roof on this damn thing yet. Alright, so let's we'll do that, and we'll do that. Let's make a bunch of that. A bunch of that for now. Alright. So we're going to have to extend this wall out just because of those. So, because I'm trying to keep this odd numbered, I am going to do two rows. Hopefully I got enough steel plate on me. Of course not. That should do her.
Meteor storm inbound.
Oh, of course. Where are you at? Oh, they're coming from there? Not a problem. I think most of that will get hit by the crater rim. Okay, maybe it's inside the crater rim. Yeah, that didn't need to be shot down, but oh well. Okay, so what I need now is I need a cargo bin for ice that needs to be ported in to the system. So up here, I'll have to put in a storage bin, connect it here, because it'll connect it to the entirety of the system. And that will be where the ice is initially stored. And then from the storage bin, it'll go to oxygen generators, which will connect to oxygen tanks and hydrogen tanks. So let's get cracking on that, I guess. Alright, so 8. I want it in line with that, and that's the block I need to take out. Put in that. So I need to get the, well, we'll leave that there like that, because I think I can get underneath here and work that. Yeah, okay. Not a problem. Alright, so we'll put that there. And then on this side, we need to pour it in with a conveyor. And just gets the plates in. Alright, so this will be our ice storage. So any ice will automatically get put here when I set up Tim to route the ice there. Okay, so from this, we need to go to a bank of oxygen generators. Now, I hear that 6 oxygen generators is enough to, when consistently filled with ice, to fill a hydrogen tank. So we're going to need to do that. Now, let's see, we got oxygen, okay. So we need, I'm going to build, I think, 10 of these instead of just 6. Want a little extra, not only for just filling up hydrogen tanks, but for oxygen tanks and backup and etc. So I also want to be able to use them to fill up my suit tanks and the like. So let's see. We can do. I want to connect this directly to that. All right, and the port is there, so we'll go here, here. Whoa! Get up there, you. You know, we'll go with 12, because it's a nice round number. Now, only these 3 are going to be connected, because if you look at the oxygen tank, you can see the box is on one side and on the opposite, but it's not on the sides, but it's also on the top and the bottom. So in order to make this work, I need to bridge these, and if I just bridge them across here, should be enough. But of course, I'll probably end up going overkill, because there ain't no kill like overkill. Oops. Alright, so, okay, in order to get to those underneath, we'll take these 2 out, so I can access these to build them, then we'll put them back in. Alright, so large steel tubes, construction components, and computers. That'll be enough for those 2. Ah, I forgot motors. Okay. We can get some motors. Oh, it's a nice sunny morning. And we can access those from the side, and these are locked in the center, so we'll have to get these 2. Alright, so I need steel plates like a mofo. Okay, so those are done. Now let's switch over to these. Okay, so here's the idea. The ice tank, or the ice storage tank, will hold every bit of ice that we harvest. They'll come through the docking ports into these tanks, which will automatically get shuttled through this whole network here of assemblers, refineries, and come to this junction pour up into this tank here and be held. Then, when they're called upon by the oxygen generators, they'll come through the side port into that oxygen generator. And they can be shuttled into this one and this one because these are in line. These conveyors up top here will transfer them to the sides. And because these are in a straight line, but they're not connected this way, they're connected this way. That's why I have these conveyors here. This will make it so that these can get ice. So we'll have to get all this patched in here. Might as well burn up all the resources we can into them that we're carrying. So we can grab more of everything. So we need steel plates and motors. Let's get down here. More steel plates. More Vespene gas required. And we'll take those, but we need to make a lot more of these, and I'm hoping I have enough iron on board, because I really hate having to harvest this stuff all the time. When I get the vertical miner, it won't be such a problem. I'll have an overabundance at that point. Trust me, it gets crazy. It mines so much, so fast. More steel plate required. Chunk off a bunch of those. There we go. That should help out a bit. Still not going to be enough. Yep. Kind of figured as much. Alright. So grab these. We'll get a few more interior plates. Construction components. Because then we can work on some of the conveyors while we're out here and waiting for more steel plate. That done. Let's get the conveyors up here first. And now the cargo. Wow, okay. And we can dump what we can onto these. Okay, these are done. Done, 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 and done, and even that one's done. Okay, so now we have a bank of 12 that should fill up, theoretically, two hydrogen tanks fairly quickly. And that's for being used on a ship, actually. Alright, so we got displays, small steel tubes, metal grids, interior plates. I just forgot everything I just said, so we'll muddle through. Maybe 100 of those. A little extra of those. Okay. You'd think with as many times as I build these things, I'd remember. Okay, so interior plate, metal grid. That's easy to remember. That's not enough. That might work. There we go. Alright, so again, we dump everything into that bin there. It'll get fed through the system into assemblers, the raw material will go through. And let me get over there. Okay, so ship comes in with a whole buttload of ore. It'll come down and dock to this. It'll get fed through here, into here. Ore will stay in here until called upon by the refineries. And when they are, it'll run through here into this, through there, through there, through there, and into all of these refineries, because they're all connected. So once the refineries are done making ingots out of the ore, it'll get fed back and be placed into this container. When the assemblers ask for ingots to make components, it'll pull them through here and into here, through the whole array of assemblers, be manufactured at super speed, and then get put back through the conveyor through here and get stored in here. Any ice that is collected, some will probably get stay in there because it's labeled for ore and ice is considered an ore, but it should get drawn mostly into this container by going through the entire system into here. Because it's matched up to these oxygen generators, at least the one that's mounted underneath this conveyor, it'll get run through those three, and then because of these conveyors, it'll get branched out to these, and then to these, and to these, and then these will get ported out to a pair of hydrogen tanks, and I'm thinking we don't need much, maybe just a pair of oxygen tanks. And that'll provide oxygen for the base, as well as for my suit, as well as hydrogen for refueling ships, as well as refueling my suit. So that's the plan, how it works out in the long run. I mean, it's worked on my other base in my off-camera game. Just, I haven't done it in exactly the same layout, so there is a difference. Alright, charge up the suit, baby. Alright, and we'll refill our tanks. And we'll dump all this stuff off. So we're doing everything that this ship is doing. This, and this, but we're doing it in a much larger, much more efficient scale in terms of assembly speed and raw output of ingots from ore. And, you know, I still have to put a wall around this thing and a roof and close it in. Yeah, there's a lot of work involved in this base, and we're only like maybe close to half done. Still got to get a pair of hydro tanks, at least a pair of oxygen tanks. I don't really see why I would need more than that, but the oxygen generators should make a lot of it really quick. Pardon me, Mountain Dew moment. And then after the hydrogen tanks, oxygen tanks, walls, and roof is put in, we're going to have to put in an airlock system and a control area. The control area essentially will have a flight seat surrounded by LCD panels with displays of this stuff, this stuff and other things that Tim can do that is relevant to getting this all done. And I might have to make some changes because I think that one docking port right there might, ought to be moved. Probably more off to the side, I'm thinking, and branching off of the components port. That's what this bin is for. And let's see, we've got to get a medical center in here. We've got to get an antenna. I got to build a mining ship from a projector, and I'll have to show you guys how that is done. Again, a lot of work is going to be involved. So I hope you guys will join me for that in the upcoming episodes. I know a lot of it will probably be branched off into next week. So, if you subscribe, you'll know when those videos come out, and you won't miss a beat. So thank you guys so much for watching. Do check out the links in the description box below, not only to get news of what's going on through my Twitter feed, which I am on daily. There's also my Patreon, but that's not as big of a deal. But the thing I mainly want to push about the description box is the links to other YouTubers, people I know, people that are starting out, people that are just building their channels, people that are well established and that I respect and believe are much more worthy of your eyes than my channel is. So do check them out. Tell them Silverblade sent you.
Meteor storm inbound.
Timing. Well, let's watch this, because that's a bang bang and okay, I think that other one's going to get by unscathed. So anyways, thank you guys for watching, and until next time, seizure later, Twitch.